Hi, Myah.
Hi.
How you doing?
Good, good.
How was your especially long summer and fall COVID-impacted off-season?
Yeah, it was definitely long. Lots of time to kind of get back in the groove of things, especially from sitting out last year. But we got sent home in March, and I actually got to go home, and I was at home. My sister got to move home, so kind of got to go back to the place where I fell in love with the game, and went back, played some games, some pickup games in the barn with Shelby, like the good old days. So it was fun to kind of go back home and find that love again for basketball. And then we got to come back here in the summer, and we just had a lot of time together to beat up on each other and play against each other. So we're really excited to play someone else here coming up soon.
How healthy are you? How are you feeling?
I feel good, really good. I'm super excited for this season.
I'll keep going. What's kind of the motivator coming into this season? I mean, last year, a very good year for you guys, but obviously coming up just short in the Summit League tournament. I would assume you guys, you know, want to get back on top in this conference.
Yes, absolutely. I think it was a tough year, a tough way to end the year last year, with the championship, and then also just the season just ended so abruptly. So I think that's it's just been kind of a motivator to see where we want to be at the end of the season. And I think we've had a good attitude coming into this very long preseason, and so I think we're ready to go.
Take a question from Sean Bauer at Kello TV.
Hi, Myah.
Hi.
You mentioned, you know, going back home and working out with your sister. You know, she went through this injury of her own. How much did you kind of lean on her to kind of help you get through all the rehab and all that?
Oh, yeah. I lean on Shelby for a lot of things, but going through an injury like that, she had just kind of, she tore ACL and was just getting back from that in her senior season. And so sitting out last year, she kind of knew what that was. She had also redshirted her freshman year, so she'd kind of been there. And so she's someone that I've always looked up to and always seems to have the answers when I don't. But I definitely leaned on her a lot during that time, and it was fun to be home with her again and get to play against each other and with each other a little bit again, just where we kind of fell in love with the game. And so, yeah, she's very helpful for me.
Does your role change at all this year? I mean, I know you played a little bit last year with Tegan gone, and then, you know, Macy and Maddie before that. I mean, are you looked upon more to kind of lead the offense and be a little bit more of a scorer than you already were?
I think so. I think the cool thing about our program is that I don't think we just ever rely on one person to do all the scoring or one person to do all the defense. We're really team oriented, and so I think that's not something that we really pin down. This person has to do that, this, that. It's we really have a team mentality, and so I think that's what makes us special. But I'm looking forward to the season and to kind of push that team mentality forward.
And then last one for me, you know, strong non-conference schedules are nothing new for you, but when you guys saw the release come out and you saw who was on the slate, just initial thoughts on that.
Yeah, I think we're really excited for it. One, just to play games again. It was fun to see the schedule come out, and then the opponents we have are our top-tier opponents, and so we're excited about that, and it really helps prepare us for our conference schedule later on. But some good challenges early in the season. We're excited.
On to Zach Borg from Dakota News Now.
Myah, granted, nobody actually ended up getting to play in the NCAA tournament last year, but this not winning the Summit League Tournament Championship is a position this program has not been in very often. It was just a couple of years ago, I know it was the other time. How much does that kind of sit with, how much does that sit with this team that, obviously you fell below kind of what had become a tradition, especially in Sioux Falls, losing that championship game where the program has historically been so dominant?
Yeah, I think we kind of, like you said, we have that tradition of wanting to win the Summit every year, and that's something that we hold ourselves to high expectations every year. So to fall short was obviously disappointing, but I think that we have a really good attitude coming into this season, and kind of the same expectations to get back to the traditions of this program.
last year, obviously, you go into the season, you don't have Macy Miller, you don't have Madison Giebert, and I think there was maybe a question of, well, who's going to be that person who steps up and you look to get points in the quote-unquote crunch time. Is that still kind of an issue with this team? I mean, who do you think plays that role? Who is looking to take, maybe whether it's you or somebody else, who does maybe kind of look to take over, maybe that's not the right word, but just kind of take the forefront in those kind of situations?
Yeah, like I kind of mentioned earlier, I think a special part of our program is just kind of that team mentality we have. But I think we all did a lot of growing last year, whether it was like finding our own kind of rhythm or individually, I think we all grew a lot. And so I think we have a lot of experience this year, and I think that's something that will kind of play out as we start playing with each other and get to take the court against other people and kind of see how things go that way. But I think we really gained a lot of experience last year, so I'm excited for this year.
Well, and the last thing I was going to ask, I know you mentioned the schedule, and certainly you're happy to be home at Frost, but as we've seen in this league, you can get an at-large bid coming out of it if you don't win the summit. So how important is it to be on your game and not just to, you know, play these teams, but you want to get these wins because this potentially does boost your resume if you win the Summit League tournament, or if you don't, you've got a good chance to hopefully get in as an at-large team.
Yeah, absolutely. I think we take a lot of pride in our non-conference schedule, and we really want to compete with the best across the nation, and getting to play these teams early on in the season is really important just for us growing towards the end of the season. But like you said, when it comes to postseason opportunities, they're obviously really big for us, so we take our non-conference schedule really seriously.
Final questions for Myah will be from Tom Neiman at Midco.
Hey, Myah, have you guys gotten into looking at Iowa State yet or not?
Not too much yet. We have a inner squad scrimmage today we're focused on, and then we'll take care of that.
All right. Haley Greer, could you tell us a little bit about her coming in as a grad transfer and being probably a point guard, it sounds like, and nobody can replace Macy Miller, but tell us kind of how Haley plays the game.
Yeah, Haley's a great addition to our team. She obviously adds a little depth there in the point guard position, but she just has a really high basketball IQ, and it's been really fun to get to know her early on here in the preseason and a little bit in the summer and then the preseason. And yeah, like I said, she just has a really high basketball IQ, and so she's just been really fun to play with. And as she's learning kind of our system and our program, I think she's done a really good job jumping in, and so I'm excited to play with her.
Yeah, all right. And last thing, Buck, it comes down to you and the Coyotes again, is what everybody's expecting. And how do we make too much out of that rivalry? Is that a big deal to you every year?
Yes, absolutely, it is. Obviously, we take most games seriously. The conference is something that we want to, a place that we want to succeed in. And but as far as it being a South Dakota kid and from South Dakota, that rivalry means a lot to me. It means a lot to our program. And so, yeah, it's a big deal. Not to make any of our other conference games less of a deal, but that's something that I think is important to us.
And do you know Chloe and some of those other South Dakota kids?
I grew up played Chloe in the state championship, and so yeah, it's kind of more personal being from South Dakota and being a Jackrabbit, and so yeah, it's a big deal.
Is this kind of an exciting week? This is kind of game week, getting ready to play this weekend, right?
Yeah, it's been a long time coming for sure. This week we worked a lot on, you know, getting used to game situations and that sort of thing. So it's been a lot of preparation, and to say that we're finally playing this Saturday is definitely surreal, and we're all really excited for it.
All right, fellas.
We'll go to Zach Borg from Dakota News now.
Hi, Leah. Your men's team doesn't actually see Frost Arena until January, yet you're going to have some pretty big games there against ranked competition. How does this feel to, not just be playing, but you're seeing some, these are marquee games, you get to have them on your home court. I know we may not have much for fans, but to get these opportunities, what is that like for this team, and how excited are you?
Yeah, I think we're always really fortunate with our non-conference schedule. We get a lot of challenging games that really test us before the conference starts up, and with times how they are now, we're definitely fortunate with our non-conference schedule. So to see be able to get those games and still have that challenge this year especially is really important, and I think it'll really help prepare us for the conference season.
Of course, you lose a couple seniors, but this time last year you were coming in, you lost the all-time leading scorer in the program's history in Macy. You lost Madison. Is everyone maybe a little more comfortable in their roles? Especially, I mean, it seems like in late game situations at time last year, we kind of wondered, well, who's going to be the, where are they going to get the points from? Do you feel like that's maybe a little more resolved now after a year away from Macy and Madison?
Yeah, I think each year people grow in their roles. I think obviously losing Macy and Maddie a couple years ago, that definitely called for a lot of us to step up in our roles. And I think this year, still losing seniors from last year, you obviously have people who need to step up and find their roles for this year. And I think we've done a really good job adjusting so far and getting comfortable with that.
And finally, how much of a chip do you come in with? How much of a chip is on your shoulder coming into this season after losing a conference tournament championship, not going to the NCAAs? That's obviously very different for this program. It only really happened once before for it to not be, you know, twice before, not go to the NCAA tournament, not win the Summit League tournament.
Yeah, I think we were lucky enough to finish our tournament and still see USD in the championship, but obviously not only me, but a lot of people on our team were able to experience that Sweet 16 run and be on that high. And then also, you know, feeling that loss in the championship. I think both of those things were really motivating, and they're going to be really motivating for a lot of our returners this year who play a big role for us.
Move to Matt Zimmer from the Argus later.
Hey, Tylee. You know, it's been a long off season, obviously, and there was so much uncertainty. Now that it's finally here and you're finally getting ready to play games, do you think it'll be difficult to, you know, kind of focus on the task at hand and prepare for games and try to compete for a championship when there's such a mentality of just wanting to play, of just trying to get the games in and have a season?
Yeah, I think it's going to be really hard not to focus on that and get, you know, kind of ahead of yourself with the schedule and looking at the games at hand. But when you really, you know, think of it, all teams across America are experiencing the same thing, and they probably had a long preseason just like we have. So we're really just gonna have to take it game by game and focus on what's at hand.
Thanks, Tylee.
We'll go to Sean Bauer from Kello TV. You're muted,
Sean. Sorry, rookie mistake there. Summer League schedule, getting back-to-back games, and you guys just happened to get USD at home. Just curious on what your thoughts are on kind of how the schedule shakes up for you there.
Yeah, I mean, we obviously love playing at home, and especially with a rivalry game like that, it'll be really different experiencing that twice in 1 year. But obviously, we know that USD comes ready to play us at home every time, and so yeah, we're looking forward to it, and it's always fun to play in Frost in that atmosphere. But I think we're still gonna have to be focused for those two games and obviously realize that they're gonna be ready for that game too. So,
and then for both sides of the ball, how big is it getting you know, Myah back, you know, fully healthy for, you know, full season?
Yeah, we're really excited to have Myah back. Obviously, she played a huge role for us a couple years ago, and we missed her last year, but now that she's healthy and she's able to contribute in, you know, many different ways as a leader, as a player, I think it'll be really important to have her back, and it'll be really good for us this year.
Final question will go to Zach Borg from Dakota News Now.
I'm curious, Tylee, I mean, I know you have the new basketball practice facility, which helps, but come February, you're going to have volleyball starting up, potentially football. I mean, it's going to be kind of crowded in the athletic department, maybe more so than normal in this winter sports season. What does everybody kind of think of just that it's how busy it's going to be? And, I mean, there's really not going to be a night. I mean, maybe there's a triple header with volleyball. I don't know. But just how crazy it's going to be to have basically every sport going at once.
Yeah, I mean, I – don't really play a part in that in deciding those things, but it'll be interesting to see for sure what how it'll all play out, but I'm sure it'll all work out in the end, so we'll see.